kickoff. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Notre Dame is lined up for the opening kickoff. So here we go. He just drills this one. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 27. The Hurricanes know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much. We could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coach has told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
First and 10. Ball on the 49. He's under some heat. Gets rid of it quickly. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Got it. Complete, and he's out of bounds. From the 37-yard line, it's first down. They'll bring him down around the 25-yard line.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
And he's level at the 13. This quarterback definitely has some confidence in his arm, Kirk.
It sure looks that way. That was well covered by the defense, and he still got it in there.
From the 13-yard line, first down. Fires incomplete.
That makes it second and 10.
Quick out to his receiver. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice eight-play, 73-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. The score now, 7-0. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the 2. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 30. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. He's under some heat. He's taken down around the 47-yard line.
Besides going deep on the fade, the slant route is probably the most commonly run route against man coverage. If the receiver gets a good inside release, it'll be a new set of downs every time.
Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made at the 40. And And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Throws in the middle. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. The slant pattern, good for about 8 yards on the play.
Well, the receiver does a nice job on his route. And how about the throw by the quarterback? Perfect execution. When those two things are going well, the offense has a good chance of picking up big yards.
He launches one for the end zone. Doesn't get there.
There was definitely an opening for the quarterback to try to squeeze that pass in. But it was just a terrific play by the safety to prevent that touchdown.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And down he goes around the 22-yard line. And he's taken down at about the 19-yard line. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he tacks on the extra point. A 10-play, 70-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard. Notre Dame gets set to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line.
Well, the last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
Tackle at the 28-yard line. Second and 9. Ball on the 28. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Around the 44-yard line, and a quick throw.
This guy's got the combination of smarts and reliability that makes a receiver really dangerous. No wonder he's looked to on third down.
From their own 44-yard line, first down. And they make the stop at about the 45. the 25-yard line. It's first down. Scrambling around. They'll bring him down at about the 21. Some time. He's taken down around the 19-yard line. So at the end of one, we're even at 7 in this one. To the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point.
Here we go.
Dumps it complete over the middle. Tackle made at the 18. Maybe a yard that time on the screen.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
Miami could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up. And it is good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Caught with room to work. He's to the 40, and he hits him hard at the 43.
That makes it first and 10.
Makes it out to about the 39. Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. They'll go with a run once again. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. Third down.
Gets to that quickly. And he's tackled at the 16.
Number 22 brings him down at the 16-yard line. First down.
Let it go, and it's caught for the touchdown. He adds the extra point. Notre Dame lines up for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 33-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He fires right.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's where you fire. That'll bring up third and six.
from their own 37-yard line. Third down.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
Fires that quickly to the tailback. They'll drop him for a loss. Fourth down upcoming as they go three and out. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there when they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
That makes it second and 10.
Notre Dame holds a 4-point lead.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. It'll be interesting to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
So the sack makes this third and very long. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's hit and taken down. From the 15, and down he goes at the 20-yard line.
Miami's coaching staff, I've got to think, going into halftime, and we're getting close right now, Kirk. They've got to do something different. What they had planned with their star running back's just not working today.
Well, I think the continuity between a coaching staff, a quarterback, and an offense is tested. Their star player is not having a great game. They're losing this football game. I think now, as we're close to this half, now is when you start to think about what other ways can we attack this defense. And then maybe eventually we get back to our star running back. But in the meantime, let's try to find some other ways to attack to be able to put points on.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Third and eight. Ball on the 22. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. He's scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack.
The quarterback didn't have any time to find the open man.
From their own 35-yard line. Second down. Got his back, but he can't hang on. Quick shot to the tailback and threw his hands. They couldn't pick up the first down, so they'll have to punt this one away.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
And they're coming after this punter. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. He's going to go for the home run. Oh, Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Notre Dame is up by four. Out of bounds at the 47. There's a strike complete, and he's tackled right away. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes, right around the 30. Notre Dame's going to take their first time out of the half. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And he's level at the 24. Gain of six on the pass, and that's good for a first down.
Heads up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Four down. Check 59. Mike is 59.
He gets hit out of bounds at about the 3-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. And he's taken down at the 2-yard line. Notre Dame is up four. Can the defense make a stop? Fourth down and goal to go. We're at the 1-yard line. Defense stacked in tight here. Shows some moves and he's in. PAT. So a 10-play, 57-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The score now, 21-10. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the three. Brought down at the 33. Quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And they push him out at the 43-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 43. Middle to his tailback. Brought down right around the 40.
Excellent job by this young quarterback of making the defense pay for bringing both outside linebackers. That's composure right there.
Throws complete and he stopped immediately. Quick throw. Tackle at the 12.
Impressive gain there by the do-it-all back.
The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. Kicks up, and it's good. It's halftime, and we've got a close one. 21-13, Fighting Irish.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two gangs match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He'll return it from the 4-yard line.
He's tackled.
The 24-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Notre Dame is up by 8. He's going to air it long. And he stays in bounds and he hauls in a big one. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 7-6.
Runs outside for a nice gain. Tackled after a decent pickup. They make the stop around the 17-yard line. He's tackled right around the 16-yard line. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Toss across the middle. He's tackled in the open field. Takes it left side and he's brought down to the backfield. From the 15-yard line, second down.
Well, Kirk, good news. We saw him go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, but apparently he's all right. It looks like he's going to get back in the action here.
He fights forward to about the 13. Notre Dame up by 8. Bring him down at the 4. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Notre Dame can make this a 2-possession game with this field goal. It's up, and he's got it. They line up to kick this one away. He'll take it from the two. And he's hammered down. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Steps out at the 26-yard line. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Just throws this one away. Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He's taken down at the 46-yard line. From the 46-yard line, it's first down. Tackled at about the 47-yard line.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Here we go. Green 19. Green 19.
It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
From the 31-yard line, first down. And they got him for a loss. He sails it long. Touchdown, Canes.
Great effort by the wide receiver. And not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. And he converts the extra point. A nice 7-play, 79-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
And a huge contribution from the aerial attack. Boy, they had some nice big pass plays on that drive.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute, put points up.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Notre Dame holds a 4-point lead. Gains his way to the 40-yard line. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. fires it out. He's at the 40, at the 30. That tackle could have saved a very big play. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. The quarterback decided to pitch it on the option, but the back had nowhere to go.
Just a perfect defensive scheme for stopping that. They got to the option before it got to them.
If they can get it in here, it'd make it a two-score game. It's third and goal. And, folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. 24-20, Fighting Irish. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Notre Dame is up by four. Got his tight end touchdown. Well, the offense certainly did their job. They've extended their lead here in the fourth quarter, and now they look at their defensive counterparts and say, hey, guys, it's your turn. He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he'll return this one from the seven. Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
Well, at this point in the game, this offense has no choice. They've got to try to get down the field as quickly as possible and come up with a touchdown. Probably an onside kick or a quick defensive stop, get the ball back and get another touchdown. So they need to execute and execute as well as they can.
Throws a strike over the middle. And down he goes around the 47-yard line. Their own 47-yard line. First down. Nice run there.
That brings him second and five.
Incomplete. The wide receiver wasn't able to hang on.
Well, you talk about a solid hit. This guy is a true enforcer.
From the 48-yard line, third down.
Here we go. Green and late.
Makes the catch and look out. And he's taken down around the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line, it's first down. Setting up play action. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. Down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. quickly to the tight end. Touchdown, Hurricanes. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion.
Six-play, 73-yard drive, and they'll come away with 6 points after failing on the two-point conversion.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
So the score now, 31-26. And down he goes at the 31-yard line.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Pocket holds. Quick pass, and he's tackled in the open field. He's brought down in the open field. And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From the 28-yard line, second down.
And he got it to the sophomore.
Brought down around the 14-yard line. Huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
Number 22 on the tackle at the 2-yard line.
Watch the run.
That makes it first and goal.
Mike is 59.
Tackle around the 1-yard line.
That brings up second and goal.
Just under 3 to go in regulation.
Touchdown, Irish. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Notre Dame lines up for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. They punched it in for 6 on the last series. Can they do it again?
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
And they make the stop at the 44. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Just under 2 to go in the game. the sack.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. And all going deep.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Here we go.
He wants it all. Great catch there before they can knock him out of bounds. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was inbounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Nice play to set up first and goal. A little over a minute in the game. For the corner. Touchdown, Miami. And he hits the PAT. It was a 7-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
He's taken down at the 45-yard line. Wow, what a fourth quarter, Kirk. Both these teams are scoring at will.
Can either one of these defenses come up with a stop? Just make a play. Otherwise, it's going to come down to who has the ball last.
This is where the offense has to come to the forefront. They work all week for situations like this. They've got the lead. They've got a chance to add to it, and that would mean a victory. He's tackled around the 44-yard line. A 1-yard gain by the halfback.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Miami's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From the 40-yard line, it's third down. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Nice run to the left there. The Hurricanes using their third and final timeout. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. Takes a knee. The Hurricanes have to look at this somehow as a positive. Their star player had a great game. They just got to look to next week.
Yeah, it's tough anytime you lose a game to be positive, but if there is anything to be positive about, it's about that performance by this individual. He really did everything that he could do to try to win this football game. Unfortunately, the team ends up losing, but they can build to the future around his abilities for sure.